So let's say you want to control the windows on your Mac with precision. You want to set exactly where they are on the screen. Now there are a lot of great third-party apps you can install that allow you to control your windows, putting them in the left half, the right half, putting them in certain spots. They have very kind of complex interfaces, I think, and unless you're doing it all the time, it's probably not worth putting an entire other extension running on your Mac. You can do it with just one line of code and get precision control. So I'm going to show you how to do it using the script editor. So let's run script editor. I'm just going to use Spotlight to search for it. So Command Space and search for script editor. And this is the editor where you could write AppleScript and also JavaScript or JXA. So I'm going to create a new document here. And the first thing I'm going to do, and this is very important, is I'm going to switch from AppleScript to JavaScript. Now you could do this in AppleScript. It's different coding. But I'm going to do it in JavaScript because you can do it in one line, and I think JavaScript and JXA are the future and AppleScript is kind of the old way of doing things. So I'm going to paste in the text here and we can take a look at it. So basically it's just got a bunch of parts, and I love that in JXA you can do this in one line. In AppleScript it would take several lines. So you've got application and then with parentheses and quotes the name of the application. Let's do Safari, and let's then have dot windows and then brackets zero. In other words, the first window. In coding, you usually start counting at zero. So window number one is zero. And so you take the first window, or in this case the only window in Safari, and then you access a property called bounds. And bounds, of course, is just like it sounds. It's the rectangle that forms the window. And then here we have a bunch of different properties. We put those in quotes with a colon and then the value and then a comma between each one with curly brackets around it. And we've got the X and the Y, the left position and the top position, horizontal and vertical. And then we've got the width and the height. So if we want to set the Safari window to be at the upper left hand corner, 700 pixels wide, 400 pixels high, we use this exact piece of code. Now it's just this one line, and all we need to do to execute it is run it. So I'm going to hit the play button. Let me move it down a bit here and you can see the Safari window in the background. Hit play and you can see it does exactly that. Moves the window to the upper left hand corner and sets its width to 700 and height to 400. Now incidentally, since Safari cannot go behind the menu bar there, setting it to zero really didn't do anything. Setting the Y coordinate to zero. For instance, if I would set it to 25, you can see it just moves down 2 pixels. That's because 23 is equivalent to 0. At 0 it's going to push it down 23 pixels so it's not behind the menu bar. But the height stays the same. It's still 400 high. So using 0 as a quick way to get it to the upper left-hand corner is fine. If you want something more specific, like you want it to be 10 pixels below the menu bar, then you would have to do 33. And you could do trial and error to figure out other similar things. You can do the same thing in Automator. I'm going to use Command Space here, run Automator, and I'm going to create in Automator a new service, which will be handy. I'm going to say it takes no input and runs only in Safari. And then I'm going to search for the run JavaScript action, put that there, put the same line of code there. So that's exactly what I had in the script editor. I can test it out, so I can in Safari here I can move this, and when I run this in Automator you can see it snapped it up there to the top left, and then I could save it as to upper left, save, and now I can find it in the Safari services menu. So say I change Safari to be some other size, I go to Safari services and I can see to upper left and it snaps it in place there. So so a handy little thing, and of course you can go and expand that if you're experienced in using JXA to pull the application from whatever application is running, or have a variety of things. You can even have multiple lines here. So you could have a script that had sets a Safari window to one location and maybe a text edit window to another location, things like that, and run these. So a lot of cool things that you can do with these if you want this kind of precision in handling your windows. For me, a big thing would be to maybe make it 1280 by 720. Therefore, when I shoot videos that show a window like Safari window, they can be an exact size to match a video that I create.